The Bible says in John 6:6. Open your Bible to John 6:6. He said, "For himself knew what to do." For himself, do what? Praise the Lord. So John 6:6 is a message. That's a Bible. This afternoon, he said, "For himself knew what to do." You see, God, he knows in advance. He knows the end from the beginning. Father Lord, we thank you. Minister to all of us, including myself. I want to be blessed of this message. I want your people as well to be blessed of this message. In the name of the Father, amen. Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. That thing you are thinking about, that which you are expecting, I'm come to announce to you that God knows what to do. Don't ever think that he's oblivious of it or is not aware of it. He knows what. Praise God. John chapter 6. After finishing his message, he said, "I don't want these people to go hungry. How can I? They have men, you know, they've been fed with the spirit of the food of the spirit, the word of God, which is the food of the spirit. Now, I don't want them to go." He saw their need. Everybody say, "He saw their need." Even though they may not complain to him, but he knew that they are hungry physically. Praise the Lord. He said, "If I enter my read Bible, I come across it. It excites me that I just love this God I'm serving. That will not leave me without help. You will get help."
Amen.
Because his name is the present help in time of need. Praise the Lord. He said, "Need meter, he meets needs. You serve a God that does what?" I'm glad to let you know that whatever even you are thinking right now, God knows what to do. Don't ever allow the lies of the devil. The devil, Jesus Christ said he's the father of lies. So you know where the lies always coming from. You'll just be seeing, hearing some things. Are you sure? Is it possible? Just say, "God knows what to do." About this matter, I may not know what's going to happen, but I'm serving a God that knows what to do. Tell your neighbor, "God knows what to do." Hallelujah. Glory be to God. For himself knew what to do. John 6:6. I'm quickly going to read from verse 5. After this, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias. Then a great multitude followed him because they saw his signs which he performed on those who were deceived. And Jesus went up into the mountain, and there he served the disciples. Now the Passover, a feast of the Jews, was near. Then Jesus lifted up his eyes, and seeing a great multitude coming towards him, he said to Philip, "Where shall we eat bread that this may be?" But this he said to test him, for he himself knew what he would do. Praise the Lord. About your station, my station, he knows what to do. It's natural to feel a bit confused, but you're not going to be confused. Just let it settle in your spirit that this God I'm serving, he knows what to do, and he will come readily for you on time. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. In John chapter 5, in Luke chapter 5, he saw that, Peter was struggling in terms of career, struggling in terms of business, struggling in terms of making ends to meet. But you check out the mind of Jesus Christ, he knew what to do. He knew how to solve that problem. And he appeared to Peter at the time of need. That same God of Luke chapter 5 will appear to you. I don't know whatever you are struggling with right now, but I know that God, Jesus says that this man, a professional fisherman, a career fisherman, still struggling, said, "Let me go and help him." The Lord will come readily for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. The present help in time of need. The present what? Write it down. My present help in time of need. Write it down. That's your message for this afternoon. My present help in time of need. He will show for you. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Now let's start from the book of Genesis, because everything has a beginning. Amen. Heaven has what? Beginning. After God created everything, all the physical things we see around us, the cosmos, you know, all the stars and whatever you call it, hallelujah, all the mammals, the plants, animate and inanimate objects, after creating them, he saw there's a need for man in you. Praise the Lord. You wouldn't want to be coming all the way from heaven to do all this, you know, coordination and minding. What did he do? He formed man. Genesis chapter 2, verse 7. The Bible says he took a dust from the ground and he formed a man, and the man became a living soul. So when there's a need for the whole world to be man, God took action. My prayer is that that need of yours, God will take action.
Amen.
God did not just create those, you know, things and then be looking. He said there's need for management. There's need for this thing to be properly put in shape. And what God did, God will inform man. Genesis 2:7. Praise the Lord. So you know that this God we are serving is always a need meter. He always knows what to do, how to meet need. He will meet your need in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And come to think of that same Genesis chapter 2, verse 18, said, it is not good for a man to be alone. Let me do what? Let me help me. You see, I love God because I know that even what I'm not thinking, I know that I need it, He will create it. May I declare over your life, even that which you have not prayed for, and heaven knows that you need it, He will give it to you.
Amen.
So when he saw the need of man, he said, I don't want this man to be alone. I will do what? Make a help. That same God is saying yesterday, today, forever. Don't repeat it. When God noticed that the man cannot be alone, he needed, you know, a companion. Hallelujah. Something that will complement his life, that will make life, you know, great for him. He created. So just have that mindset that anything that you need is within his capacity. He has the ability. That's why he's called a creator. He will create it for you. In John 14:14, he said, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it for you. That even if it's not available, I will create it. Praise the Lord. If it's going to make him to create what you need, he will do it. Praise the mighty Jesus. I say, praise the mighty Jesus. The Lord is good. Genesis chapter 22. What gives us this assurance that our needs will be met? Hallelujah. When God asked Abraham, take your son, your only son, the one that you love. Genesis 22, read from verse 3. Praise the Lord. God bless you. You are connected. Amen. He's in the spirit. Amen. So what I'm saying is that we are here this afternoon to settle that matter once and for all. Don't let the devil intimidate you that your need cannot be met. Because the God we are serving knows what to do per time. Anything that he needs to put in place for your sake, he will do it. Hallelujah. Genesis 22. Glory be to God. When God asked, what's his name, Abraham, he said, go and offer your son, your only son, God bless you, the one you love. God is not a murderer. Praise the Lord, God bless you. God is not a murderer.
God is not a murderer.
Before he asked Abraham to do that, he already made a provision. So I'm declaring to you this afternoon, your provision is waiting for you. This week, I said your provision is waiting for you. At the time he was giving Abraham that instruction, praise the Lord, he already made a provision. This God is good. Praise the mighty Jesus. That's why when God commissions you, there's a provision in place. Don't be afraid to embark on any project. If God is in need, don't be afraid of provision. If you have seen the vision, and he says, son, daughter, go ahead. Don't be afraid of provision. Tell your neighbor, don't be afraid of provision. Because God knows how to meet that which has committed unto you. Pray and pray the mighty Jesus. So when he asked Abraham to go and offer his son Isaac. A ram, the cattle was already waiting. All he wanted to know is whether Abraham has the faith to carry through. That's what God is looking for. That the message of this morning. What is it? You know, God already has the end in mind. Shout hallelujah. God already has what? If he gives you an instruction, don't be afraid to carry it out. Don't say where will the provision come from? How will I be able to meet the need? How will this project be completed? It's already completed in the mind of God. Praise the Lord. He said, go and offer your son, the only son, the one you love. And the natural question, you know, Isaac asked his father, this is firewood. This is matches. Where is the object of sacrifice? What was Abraham's response? That's God you are serving. Don't be intimidated by needs. Don't be intimidated by whatever you are believing God for. The provision is already in place. He said, it is not good for him. He himself said it. It is not, I don't find justifiable. I don't find, you know, anything wrong in making provision for this man. For this man shall not be alone. I will make a help for him. This week, your help of destiny is on the way.
Amen.
That need, anything that God needs to do to meet that need, whether by miracle, whether by connection, he's going to do it. Glory be to God. Genesis 22. Instruction was given to Abraham, Genesis 22, verse 2. But by the grace of God, between 9 and 14, provision was in place. As you take that step of faith this week, the provision will be there for you.
Amen.
I say it will be there for you.
Amen.
In the precious mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now listen to this. When Jacob was struggling, I know Jacob was a supplanter. He's a deceiver, manipulator. Praise the mighty Jesus. But he made a covenant with God, you know, Genesis 28, when he was going to, you know, run into Laban, his uncle's house. But the time when he got to, you know, his uncle's house, Laban, he met with a struggle. Praise the Lord. He met with a senior manipulator. Praise the Lord. He is a manipulator, but he met his match. Hallelujah. Because his wages was changed 10 times. He saw somebody that is more tough than him. Amen. He ran to the Lord, what do I need to do? And God saw the need of that man. He saw the struggle. He saw the heart of that man and said, you know what? Angel of the Lord, he said, my angel, go and show him how to multiply cattle. God saw him in the need, the struggle, in the midst of the struggle, and the Lord of heaven made a way for him. That same God who calls himself the way, make a way for him.
Amen.
He did not allow him to end up as a struggler, as a young man frustrated in the house of Jacob, in the house of Laban. He made a way. He opened his eyes on how to multiply cattle. Praise the Lord. This God is good. My prayer is that your next project will not fail.
Amen.
How to go about it, how to embark it, how to, you know, make it to be a success, he will show it to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. He made a success out of the struggle of Jacob. He showed him how to rear cattle. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is good and all the time. So my prayer this afternoon, that as we are believing God for the next door to open, we open for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
How does God go about this one? How will God be able to meet your needs? Praise the Lord. For instance, in 1 Kings chapter 17, open your Bible to 1 Kings chapter 17. The Bible says, when the brook dried up, Elijah was by the brookside. He was being fed by the angel. But suddenly, that source of supply ran out. And you think that God will abandon him there? No. He did not. He saw that the brook, you know, ran out, cried, but God quickly made a provision, said, I've commanded a widow. Is that in your Bible? When the source of his supply ran out, God is saying, no, that will be the end of it. He said, I've commanded a widow to take care of you. My prayer continually for you is that they need to always be met. They need to always be met. If it seems, oh, this one is like, this thing is just like, it's almost gone. No. God will replenish it.
Amen.
I say, God will replenish it.
Amen.
In the precious mighty name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I say, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is good. And all the time. Amen. Now look at this. In 1 Kings chapter 17. And Elijah the Tishbite, you know, just came from the blues. Hallelujah. The Lord is good. He said, verse 3, he said, get away from here and turn eastward and hide by the brook of Cherith, which flows into the and it be that you shall drink from the brook, and I've commanded the ravens to feed you there. So God uses elemental forces to meet our needs. Praise the Lord. Elemental what?
Forces.
All these things he created, no, angels, birds, animals. Praise the Lord. Because as his beck and call, God can meet your need anyhow, somehow. And that's my prayer. Praise the Lord. Even the where you least expected, God will show up.
Amen.
Some of us, we think only, you know, it's only a color people that can, you know, be able to get, you know, even color is a struggle with color. But may God help you if you have color people working with you. Praise the mighty Jesus. You think you are going to get the best results from them? You'll be disappointed. May God help this color. I said, may God help this color. In the name of Jesus. Out of jealousy, out of what? I don't even know what to say about us. It's only God that can deliver us. Where you're supposed to find your kit and kin to help you, they are the ones that will be, you know, just to, you know, make you to fall into the what do you call it now? Dig a bit for you. But that's not what I'm saying this afternoon. Praise the mighty Jesus. But what I'm saying is that even if he's going to take God, I mean his angels, he's going to mobilize his angels to meet you, he's going to go. Say, you know what? He said, I have commanded, is that your Bible? As for I have commanded the ravens to feed you there. You see, one thing that usually surprised me about God is that you use unlikely things to settle matter. Ravens, praise the Lord, these are carnivorous birds. The same thing in 1 Kings chapter 7:19, when Elijah said, I want to die now, God sent a bird that eats flesh. You will expect that the rain will feed on the flesh of Elijah. No, he has been commanded not to touch Elijah. Praise the mighty. But what I'm saying here is that God can use any means, anyhow, to meet your need. And that's my expectation for all of us in the name of Jesus. Whichever way he's going to do it, because the Almighty, he knows what to do. He knows the how is of him. He knows how to meet the need, and he's going to do for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So he went and did according to the word of the Lord, for he went and stayed by the brook Cherith, and which flows into the Jordan. Rather, the ravens brought him bread and meat. Ravens, Bordo brought him what? Food. Praise the Lord. Verse 7. And it happened after a while, the brook dried up. What do you do next? As human being, where he was getting the supply, the brook was now dried up. The source of income will not dry up.
Amen.
Whatever you rely on will not dry up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He said, because there had been no rain, and God didn't stop there. He said, no, I've commanded a widow. The next thing God will do by way of provision is that he took another step. If this won't fail, I've already have, you know, a plan in place. That's why, you know, devil made that mistake in Genesis chapter 3. Because while he was trying to get man out of relationship with Almighty God, was of God already taken ahead. He said, the son shall bruise the head, and the Satan bruise the leg. And that's what happened on the cross. While Satan was doing his own thing in Genesis chapter 3, God was wiser. God has taken an advanced step. Concerning you, God will take advanced step in the name of Jesus. Far beyond your expectation. In the name of. So when the book dried up, what happened next? God create another avenue. He did not allow his servant to suffer. You are not going to suffer.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. So God can use elemental forces Don't be afraid when you see certain strange things happen. And I'm saying good things, strange things, but surprises. Say that be like a surprise. How is it possible? How can this, you know, come from this particular source? That's God for you. Where you least expected, God will show up. In the name of Jesus. That's why God is God. He can come from any direction. You can't box him. If he says he's going to come from north, he can come from south. He can come from the east. Praise the Lord. The Lord is good. And all the time. Your needs are met in Jesus. So number one, he can use elemental forces. He can also decide to do it by himself. Perform a miracle. In Acts chapter 16, you know the story very well. When Paul and Silas were locked up in the prison, God by himself did release them by his own power. He said there was an earthquake. Acts chapter 16, 24 to 26, there was an earthquake. There was a shaking. And suddenly the prison door opened on his own accord without using key. Praise God, because he is the door. And any door he opens, no man can close. Concerning you, the door the Lord has opened for you in this land, it will not be closed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is good and all the time. In 1 Samuel chapter 1, the Bible also records, you know, the experience of this man, woman called Hannah. Hallelujah. When everything seems like it's not going to be possible, God enter into a covenant with her. He said, be able to give me, you know, be able to promise that your son will serve in my house, then get ready for your womb to be open. Somebody's womb is open right now.
Amen.
In the precious mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So God can send an angel or do it by himself or even by way of speaking to somebody's life through his prophets. Through what?
His prophet.
Prophetic utterances. So God can send forth to you, you know, his own servant to declare over your life that the struggle is over.
Amen.
And I'm saying that this afternoon that the struggle is over.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible says, you know, 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 10, said, believe your Lord, your God, shall be established, and believe your prophet, and you shall prosper. 2 Chronicles. So God can use, bring, you know, his own servant your way to declare over your life that that door is open, that struggle is over. And I'm clear here to announce to you this afternoon that the struggle is over.
Amen.
In 2 Kings chapter 2, for instance, in the land, they needed peace in that land because nothing was working. Everything was barren. Let's open our Bible to 2 Kings. So God can send, you know, a servant at a time, at a point of need, to release one from any form of bondage or oppression. So God can use angels, elemental forces. God can come by himself. God can send a man of God, you know, your way. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The Lord is good. And all the time. 2 Kings chapter 2. So I'm here as the representative of the Almighty God with all sorts of humility to declare over your life that your need is met.
Amen.
I say your need is met.
Amen.
In the precious mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Lord is good. And all the time. After Elisha, you know, got the mantle from Elijah, hallelujah, he went to a city. Verse 19, then the men of the city said unto Elisha, the Bible says, you know, verse 17, he's talking about, you know, he got to, you know, the Jericho and the less of it. Then verse 19 says, then the men of the city said to Elisha, please notice the situation in this city is pleasant as my Lord says, but the water is bad and the ground is what? It's barren. So they have a need. They have what? And the next thing is that by the grace of God, God will use the prophet Elisha to speak over that problem and the problem became a testimony. I'm saying this afternoon, under the unction of the Holy Spirit, that that concern of yours become a testimony.
Amen.
I thought I would hear your amen.
Amen.
Then the men of the city said, came to Elisha, you know, we have problem, we have a need here. This land is barren, nothing is working. Hallelujah. And he said, bring me a new bowl and put the salt into it. So they brought it to him. And then he went out to the source of the water and cast in the salt there and said, thus says the Lord, I'll fill this water. Here, thus says the Lord, your station is here right now.
Amen.
He said, I've healed this water. From it there shall be no more death or barrenness. Rest up on your feet. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because you don't have all the time. Praise the Lord. I want to keep the time. I think it's even after time already. So my prayer this afternoon, the God that says He knows what to do. That need of yours is settled.
Amen.
I want you to rise up on your feet and begin to pray. Tell God. Now, if peradventure there's going to be any crisis, you know, in the economy, or it's going to be any kind of, you know, layoff or lay down or whatever, I claim exemption. Because the need of my family shall be met. Would you turn that to prayer right now? As the Lord, whatever is going to happen in the economy, you know how to meet the needs. You know how to meet the needs of your people. You know how to meet the need of your people. Lord, I declare this afternoon that whatever is going to happen, COVID-19 or second wave or whatever, you know what to do. I claim exemption under the unction of the Holy Spirit. I claim exemption. Whatever is going to happen in the land, whatever is going to happen in the environment, Lord, I claim because of the need of my family, because of the need of the church, because of the need for the gospel, Lord, I pray, I claim exemption right now in the precious mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. The Lord is good. The Lord said we should help one of us in prayer right now. You're under the fear of what's going to happen next. But the Bible says, looking up to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, you will not lose that joy. In fact, let me tell you this good news. Because he himself knew what to do. And the God that preserves, he preserved his own people. He said, my people shall not see when heat comes. He said, my people shall be satisfied in times of famine. I decree right now, that job is preserved.
Amen.
He said, you should not entertain fear. Because fear is a torment. Your needs, in the midst of all scarcity, austerity, that prosperity.
Amen.
I say, in the midst of austerity, that prosperity.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you, Lord. Glory be to your name, Lord. In Genesis 47, the Bible says, in Egypt there was famine, but his own people in Goshen, they were preserved, they were multiplying. In that same order, in the midst of this chaos, there will be a Goshen for you.
Amen.
You didn't hear that prayer. I said, in Egypt, there was a Goshen, a place reserved for his own people, a place of flourishing, a place of flourishing, a place of multiplication, a place of supply, supernatural supply. In that same order, enter your Goshen.
Amen.
In that place of work, enter your Goshen.
Amen.
The Lord said, I should say, in order of Genesis 20 for someone right now, all the effort you have been making is like being frustrated. There's nothing new under the sun. The same thing happened to Isaac. He was digging the well. He was meeting with frustration. Kept digging. Only come to his real world. I declare that individual right now. From this moment, enter into your real world.
Amen.
A place of settlement.
Amen.
A place where there's no contention.
Amen.
They were contending with
you know, Isaac all the way, as he was digging, they were filling it up, they were frustrated, all frustrating his effort. From this day forth, no more frustration.
Amen.
No more frustration.
Amen.
Your effort in the office will be appreciated.
Amen.
No frustration.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. The struggle is over.
Amen.
Oh, that young man kept digging and digging and digging. And he kept forcing and frustrating until that time when God said, enough is enough. I've come to announce to someone right now, enough is enough.
Amen.
The struggle is over.
Amen.
In the name, the stress is over.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And Jesus himself terminated. He saw the need of Peter in Luke chapter 5 and said, I've seen you toiling. I've seen your sweat. It is now turned to sweet.
Amen.
Sweetness. Your sweat will turn to sweetness.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank
you, Father. Glory be to your name, Lord. Before the end of this year, God said, I should profess one of us here, as the Lord liveth. Whatever seems to be like a carryover, it's like year in, year out, is the same thing, like story. No, like something that is like repeating itself, very repetitive. But this year, will bring an end to repetition.
Amen.
Because when you send a child to school, by the time that child finishes and then keep repeating, you know, that is not, it's not a glow, it's not bringing good news to the family. I decree right now that year in, year repetition of the same story will turn to glory.
Amen.
Listen to me carefully. That destiny helper, he said, I don't want this man to be alone. He saw the need of Adam in Genesis chapter 2, verse 18. I say this afternoon, this same God that made a provision for Adam, your own bone of bone is here right now.
Amen.
Your own flesh of flesh is here right now.
Amen.
He said, it's not good for him to be here. He saw the need. He saw the need for companionship. He's so need for someone to compliment him. I decree over someone right now, in the name of every other name, that same, the way God meet that needs, met the need in Genesis 3, he will meet your need right now.
Amen.
I mean, Genesis 2, 8, rather, he will meet your need right
Amen.
Now. In the name of Jesus. When he saw people about to go hungry, he made a provision. You not go hungry.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's begin to appreciate Jesus. Let's do the Holy Covenant quickly. God bless you. God bless you.